Yeah, and if you leave the video off, we'll just assume you're in the car or lying in your bed, and then we're gonna boot ya. Okay, reloaded. Don't make me call names, everybody. I can read. There we go.
Bless you, David.
Let's get videos up. Outstanding. 347 and climbing. If you haven't already, one last call here. Let's make sure that we are changing our names. Office name, first name, last initial. Managers, let's get a little help here. We'll start in 60 seconds. First name, last initial. Let your dogs know, SC1 starting. Let your dog know. No, but seriously, let them know. Outstanding. Welcome to Summer Conference 1. Spanning the globe. Oh, yeah. If you're not smiling right now, you got to get off this call. There's like one of you. Like, what? How can you not be pumped? It's SC1. Or you can go get off the call and be on SC None. Your choice. Let's welcome everyone. Summer Conference 1. Let's go. Uh-huh. All right. Oh, we are about that time, everybody. Welcome to Summer Conference 1. I'm going to turn things over very quickly to my colleague, friend, and co-host, Mr. Andrew Evans from the Florida coast. Just a couple of quick thoughts on Zoom etiquette before we get started. Just a friendly reminder, okay? Number one, being present. And I think for the time, money, and energy that you're spending today to be here, you want to be here, right? They always say, wherever you are, be there. And if you're at SC1, be present today. That means putting yourself in a place physically that's going to be the best possible spot to absorb, letting people around you know what's going on, letting your annoying little brother or sister know, hey, not come in and do what you normally do when I'm on these meetings, making sure you let mom and dad know, making sure you're staying hydrated and feeding yourself during the meetings to stay engaged, making sure you're sitting up attentive at a desk, not lying down on the couch, not lying down on the bed, and certainly not driving because you don't want to get the boot. And then you have to go to the other conference. That's called SC None. Okay? So we're going to keep everyone on mute except for the managers. We have an action-packed agenda today. And Mr. Andrew Evans, my co-host and division manager from Florida Coast, I'll turn things over to you.
Thank you, Jeff. Well, I am excited and fired up to kick off our SC1 event today. And we'll not really kick it off, but turn things over to my colleague, Jeff Gamboa, here in just a second. If it's your first SC1 conference, I want to welcome you to our event today. I want to welcome you to the divisions, whether you're in Florida Caribbean or Florida Coast. We're super excited to have you guys here. Today's going to be a jam-packed event. And I think, again, if you show up 100% engaged, if you're showing up the right way, success is a choice. And so choose and make the choice to get the most out of the event today. I'm going to go ahead and turn things over to the division manager for the Florida Caribbean division. For those of you guys that have not met him before, Jeff Gamboa is the divisional manager for the Florida Caribbean division. I have had the pleasure of working with Jeff for many, many years, and he is, if not, one of the most prolific division managers in the entire company. He's originally from Baltimore, Maryland, and he's got a legacy and a career filled with success everywhere from the representative level, from being the number one sales representative in the entire company his first summer on the job as a student in Baltimore, Maryland, to eventually becoming one of the top performing district managers, one of the fastest promoted division managers in the company, and doing so well in his area that they made him fly down to South Florida and take what was probably at one time one of the worst regions of the entire company. And so, the company had some kind of smarts behind them. They said, look, this whole South Florida thing is a higher concentration of soccer moms than probably any other part of the country. We got to get things going down here. And Jeff Gamboa was the guy, came down here in 2009 and has since forth created not one, but two of the most powerful and ass-kicking divisions here in the entire company. in terms of people, performance, culture. I'm privileged to be able to call Jeff one of my good mentors and friends. And I'm excited to turn things over him to light you all on fire and kick off what will be an epic SC1 event. So without further ado, Jeff, Division Manager for the Florida Caribbean Division.
Thank you, Andrew. Hey, you know, it's temperature-wise really hot outside. Currently, my wife and I, we reside in South Florida in the heart, downtown Miami. I know in Puerto Rico, it's flaming hot. I know all across the board, but I can tell you the hottest event in all of Vector Marketing is right now, June 9th, here with the two divisions, Florida Coast and Florida Caribbean. You like how I did that? I like it as well. Welcome. I want to share a few thoughts that as my friend and colleague Andrew kicked off, I want to set the tone for the meeting today, but I want to go quickly, let you know that, you know, a couple of years ago, all but 4 or 5 years ago, believe this, okay? 4 years ago, many of you on this call were at this meeting as a representative. Many of you on this call sat when we put two divisions that had never worked together and we started a division called Florida United and said we were going to build the nastiest, the best, the most dynamic organization in vector marketing history. In 2017, we started out with this very small hodgepodge of people, right? From the U.S. Virgin Islands to Puerto Rico, all the way through Florida. And I had the opportunity and privilege of working alongside. And in 1 year, we built a squad. And in 1 year, we already turned heads. And 1 year later, we were the premier organization at events, and we continue to be the premier organization. And in 2020, this unbelievable team has now spread its wings, as now we have two divisions, Florida Caribbean and Florida Coast, that have come from our organization. I want to just kick things off and say welcome. My name is Jeff Gamboa, and I am the proud division manager for our Florida Caribbean division, one of 44 across the country. And I want to also give props, who I'll introduce him a little bit later on, Mr. Andrew Evans, our Florida Coast division coordinator. So excited to be here for all of you. So excited to talk about being a five-star recruit. And we'll talk about that more so in Andrew's message. So excited to talk to you about Leadership Academy today. You know, what are the things that you can take from this event that change the trajectory of your life? And I want to say that again so that you write it down and that you process. The Knife virtual meeting, the crazy meeting with the fun guy and got the two guys running the division, AKA Cookies and Cream Tandem over here, right? Andrew and Jeff. Okay, yeah, I said that. Right? It's going to go from, oh, this fun event and another Knife meeting to that event from 10 to 4 changed the trajectory of my life. And co-hosts, let's make sure we're muting people as they're hopping on. We're getting a little bit of feedback, okay? Changing the trajectory of your life from a business, from a personal, from a professional standpoint. You know, when we think about SC1, this isn't just another training. This isn't just another Zoom. The objectives of the meeting are clear. We want to recognize top performers today. And boy, do we have some events to do that. Do we have a countdown. We have prizes. We have the ability to just recognize and highlight performers. Get on our radar. Number two, high-powered instruction. Oh, man, did Andrew and I recruit some best of the best speakers today. We've got Mr. Taylor Max Ricard, one of our most prolific Cutco sales professionals, teaching you his demo and how to present his sets. We've got Mr. Dylan Fitz, one of our Cutco sales professionals from Tampa, one of the most consistent people in the history of our company, not just as a rep, as a student, but period, as a professional. And we have Mr. Luke Maseko, who's going to give instruction, one of our top premier new district managers in the entire company, to talk to you about dropping down and really closing set orders today. So let me take 30 seconds. And how do you get the most out of this event? If this isn't another training, if this is different, well, then how in the world do I get something out of this? Well, number one, you got to keep it 100 with your engagement. You have to, right? And by now, and I'm going to say it this way, you've already gone through 2 days of training with us. Most of you have been through an advanced training. Some of you are a couple of weeks old. By now, you know the difference. Think of all the people that never had their video up, that kept going to get something to eat, that kept lying down on the couch during the training. They are not here. They're at the other conference, summer conference, none. Okay? So it's important to stay engaged. It's important to observe virtual etiquette. It's appropriate and exciting to recognize people. Right? And that's the vector culture. The vector culture is you perform, we want to just say thanks, and we want to applaud and recognize you. And you know what? One of the things you can do to get the most out of this event is work on getting better. Don't be bitter, be better, right? Don't sit here and complain. Don't be a hater. Oh, I wish I were selling or they're selling. Ready? You're here because of what we want to happen after the conference. Take action. What are you going to do after this event? Are you going to leave this event and then just mail it in and take the next couple 24 hours off and then just show up to your team meeting? Or are you going to capitalize and say, I'm leaving here with 2 to 4 appointments tonight, or I've got a full day booked tomorrow? That's the key. Do you leave into action? And ready, focus on being better. You know, one of the things I encourage you to do, if you see a slide, if you see something motivational, if you see an instructional slide that you love, hurry up and screenshot that from your laptop. And we'll send the keynote out for everyone afterwards. If you really want a professional, we'll send the whole thing out. All of our speakers have all of their documents and their keynotes available. Make today about a light bulb moment. Whether you're from Florida Coast, which represents the west coast of Florida and the Metro Miami area, or you're from Florida Caribbean, which is the south side of Florida, West Florida, including Fort Myers and Puerto Rico, we both believe in the concept of light bulb moments. How do you create a light bulb moment today? So before we start, allow me to show off a bit, if I may. Allow me to tell you how awesome our company is doing right now, and allow me to get you pumped to be part of this unbelievable championship organization. The growth and the excitement. When you thought you were just selling knives sitting in your kitchen to grandma, nope. When you thought, oh, I'm just going to get into this leadership academy to look good on my resume for a summer, nope. You are working for the largest distributor, the number one manufacturer of high-quality kitchen, American-made products, guaranteed forever. And I'm just excited to show off a little bit. Can I show off a little bit? Well, let me show off that Cutco has expanded now. You might not know this, but we are now expanding into Cutco stores. Check this out. A lot of you have been doing this virtual. All of our offices have a home-based office where we do all of the trainings and all the recruiting. But there are now offices expanding into this beautiful monstrosity known as the Cutco retail office. Look at that. So the front is a retail office, right? Only the Cutco nerds drool on this one, right? You look at this and you're like, oh, right? It's got the names and uses everywhere. It's got all the knives. And ready? Smart. Twice a week, they do cooking classes with the Mac soccer moms to get them pumped about the product, broadcast it on the internet, and there you go. Okay? So just expansion. I want you to think bigger, light bulb moments. You're a sports fan. I'm just going to list what I know of 5 or 6 teams, including the Chicago Bears, the Cleveland Cavaliers, home to South Florida, the Panthers, the Marlins, and the awesome Dolphins. And the awesome Dolphins. I want you to know that across the board, these are just a few, a fraction of the professional teams that utilize Cutco for their suite owners. One of the number one highest revenue creating parts of the NFL leadership are suite ownership, corporate and CEO ownership. And one of the most prominent gifts that they give, you guessed it, is our awesome product. Maybe that's a light bulb moment for you. Did you know that Dr. Phil had our awesome product? Catch me outside on January 6, 2012. How about that? Right? Think about that. Right? Cutco was on Dr. Phil and he gave away, I believe, 300 galleys that day to the audience. Think about that. It's promoting the best product. So maybe that's a light bulb moment to help you think about our company. Do you know that Cutco has fair and show and kiosk and holiday programs available? If you're high enough in sales, if you're a Cutco sales professional, or if you're $100,000+ in sales as a college student, you have the opportunity to work fairs and shows. This is the Fort Lauderdale Boat Show, one of the largest boat shows in the country. There's Mariana and Taylor Max, who you'll hear from today, standing with their professional kit and booth, presenting to people as they walk by in excess of 20,000 to 30,000 attendees. And in weekends, they're generating 30, 40, 50, up to $100,000 in sales. I think about going to local fair like Mariana here over in Brickell in downtown Miami. Look at the Brickell. It's this a Taste of Brickell festival. Okay, and I think about the malls, Plaza Las Americas. I think about International Mall in Tampa. I think about Galleria Mall here in Fort Lauderdale. I think about during the holiday season having a kiosk run by one of our top sellers selling tens of thousands of dollars worth of Cutco. Hopefully another light bulb for you. I think about the number one most important people that we need to sell to. Those are homeowners. And I think the people that we have a co-partnership are, of course, us selling the product for the home, but the people that are selling the home. And we have a realtor program where if you're out of college or you're into a career type position, we have the opportunity for our representatives to work with real estate agents to create CGC, what's called a Cutco gift and consulting gifts. So these representatives don't sell Cutco in the home. What they'll do is they'll go to real estate offices and sell tens of thousands worth of Cutco to real estate agents as reoccurring gifts. So maybe that's another light bulb you didn't know about our amazing company. you know, I've been talking a lot about what we're doing, what we're selling, how we're performing. How about what we're giving? How about what we give to the community? I can't tell you from the advocacy of all types of people, from the ability to support. And my, one of our favorite near and dear to South Florida is Angel Wings International, one of many, many. The other one I would say is Tampa Bay, PB&J, Mike Abramitz and the Tampa team. I hold Angel Wings near and dear to my heart because I was there for when it started. In 2012, Andy Jonte, one of the most prolific sellers, over $3 million in Cutco sales, lost a few of his family members in the earthquake in Haiti. And he made a pledge to raise money to create a health clinic in his hometown of Jacmel, Haiti. And it's funny because a couple of years later, we broke ground. A couple of years later and several hundred thousand dollars later, we started building and giving Cutco away. If you notice on the left, for free, we're giving away free Cutco cookware. That's awesome. And I'm proud to say that because of our Cutco efforts, because of our Cutco team and the care that we have for giving back, we have a fully functional free healthcare clinic in Jacmel, Haiti. Just one of many examples of the company we support that we work for. But it wouldn't be a Vector meeting if we didn't talk about how we're performing, would it? It wouldn't be a Vector meeting if we didn't talk about our Silver Cup standings. If you don't know, the Silver Cup represents a very elite trophy, and there's about 20 to 25 categories where the top number one performer in that category will receive our coveted Silver Cup. It's given away at our year-end awards night. I want to recognize all the people on the Silver Cup report. In the Cutco Sales Professional Rising Star League from Clearwater, Florida, one of my favorites, Miss Kathy Orr, representing the Clearwater team. Congratulations, and Kathy, it's still early. It's not even halfway through the summer, but if it were to end today, number 10 in her respective category. In the Rising Star Cutco Sales Professional category, we have two on this call, both from Florida Caribbean on the top 20. We have Aaron from Fort Myers representing the Fort Myers team, and then Yvonne Irasari, one of our favorites, one of the OG, old school Cutco sellers, representing San Juan, number 9 in her category. One of my favorite things to recognize are team builders, people who are helping to build our organizations. I just want to start off by saying thank you for working so hard when you're recommending friends. I know the Cancun trip helped. I know the free prize that the different offices are giving, from swag gear and clothes to AirPods to whatever they're giving away. But I want you to know that building a championship team is a big deal for us. I want to recognize in the entire country, we have several on this Zoom that are representing themselves at a high level. Number one on the entire Zoom today, Liliana Orozco, based on her PRs and her PR team, number 10 in the entire company, okay? Number 43, number 44, both from Florida Caribbean, with Natalia from San Juan, Isabel Silver from Naples. I also wanna show, look at all the individuals here from the AMs, right? Liz Maseko, number 9 in the country, Alejandro, we have all the way down, recognizing some of our top assistants for setting personal and having personal recruits. Also, I want to recognize specifically, right, Liz from Boca, number 9 in her AM category. We've got Alejandro from San Juan, Casey from Fort Lauderdale, Amanda Swanson from Tampa. What's up, Amanda? And then Jonathan, assistant in St. Pete. And then off to the office competition. So this is general office sales. And if you look just overall, there are three categories. Pilot, which is an office that Andrew and I run. There's 44 of us. Elite, which are the veteran offices. And then the Premier League. Right now, if we were to end today, what a close race. The Tampa team, led by Amanda Swanson and Jess Shannon, and I guess Mike's important too, right? Right? That of organization going for its back-to-back Silver Cups. But I'll tell you right now, it is a very, very close race in Tampa. So Tampa, between you know, I can't be biased, but I want you to crush Chris. Okay, cool. Not to be biased. Number two, the Premier League, San Juan, Puerto Rico. I spoke to David Vargas at the beginning of the year, and he said, we're going to win a Silver Cup. We might win too. David, you are on pace now, moving very quickly. I just had their biggest week ever, San Juan, number 6 in their respective category. To the new district office competition, Rising Star represents new managers within their first full year. I'm proud to say on this call, we have two individuals in their first full year, number 14, Claudia Badillo, number 14 in the company, and then the Boca team led by Luke and Liz, number 4 in their respective category for the Silver Cup. Okay, so very close, so you can see there, Luke and Claudia, congratulations. and then Eddie De Las Cuevas and the Clearwater team. New District Manager League represents first 8 months open. So congratulations, Eddie, on a nice start. And I emphasize start because here comes Clearwater. Also, I want to recognize our district team competition. This is the district manager and any students in TLA that they've developed to help run a branch Cutco internship. We combine the sales, and it's almost like a family team competition. Well, number 19 in the company, Luke Maseko and the Boca Raton district team. Number 15, David Vargas and the San Juan district team. And then Mike, again, looking to defend his back-to-back Silver Cup championship here. Number one currently with a healthy league, healthy lead rather. But, man, I just let's take it higher, all three offices. Congratulations on being the report. You know, there are some reports that come a little closer to the heart. And I got to say, the branch competition has a little near and dear place in our hearts. Here's why. Because Andrew and I both ran branch offices. I ran one at a pretty high level. Andrew ran it at the most elite championship record-breaking level. And since then, for the last 5 years, we have had the top branches in the entire country. For the past 3 or 4 years, the number one Eastern Region branch and top branches nationally, including last year, Mason Linker and Milena Amy. This year, if it were to end today, we would have 10 on this Zoom out of 300 to 400 plus branch managers finishing in the top 10. Christina Fernandez and the Ponce team just getting started. Mason Linker and the St. Pete team. Mason is our defending number one branch manager from the Eastern Region last year. Marley Lewin and the Naples squad, number five. Jonathan Castell and the Doral office, number four. And then Alejandra Carrasco, number two in the nation. This is as of tabs last week, does not include what we just sent up for the week on Monday. Okay, so congratulations there. And then this is overall for just the district team Silver Cup, like overall standings. And man, you talk about Florida Caribbean and Florida Coast. What an exciting thought to have a 1-2 finish. Let's keep the cup in Florida and Puerto Rico. But let's keep it in the southeast corridor. This is pilot development. This is anyone that's developed from our pilot specifically. And really, this is a Boca Raton Luke and a pilot Mila competition. So really, it's just the two of us. There's some guy named Brian Herman at the top. Let's make a run. And I want to give props to Florida Caribbean right now, ranking in two different categories for divisional sales. On the left side, you got total sales, number 9 in the company. And on the right side, top 8 new business sales, currently number 5. Last year, Florida Caribbean finished number 2. We're going to make a run this year at number 1. Just want to show you how great we're doing. I want to show you how great you're doing. And I want to say thanks, and we're only getting started. So before we get started, I want to kick off this meeting by doing some formal introductions. I want to tell a quick story on how you can get the most out of the opportunity, and then I'm going to turn things over to my colleague and friend for our push countdown, Mr. Andrew Evans. I want to give props to your fast starters. If you just started on Friday, I honor you because, and I respect you because you trust us. You're here and you just started Friday. And I'm going to tell you from experience, my fast start ended with Summer Conference 1. I can tell you the choice you've made to put your energy and time today, it's well worth it. And no matter what happens, I don't care if you're number one and having 10, 20K fast starts, or you're struggling, you are here and you want to get better. And that makes the difference for all of us. I want to recognize all of our 10K fast starters. Man, oh man, I can't wait till quarantine's over. You know why? Because Andrew and I have a lot of money to spend on a lot of 10K fast starters. And this is a 10K in your first 10 days. Also during the push, VIP night, where Andrew and I are hosting all across Florida and Puerto Rico, different events. These are just some different pictures of past events with private room, private dining. This is an old school 2017. Many of the people here who were representatives and lower tier managers are now running Florida Caribbean and Florida Coast. And this is one of our messages. Several of you, Alex Arias, Julia Ortiz, are here, Andrew and I hosting one of our many, many VIP nights. So congratulations to all of our 10K fast starters. I told you the branch manager update really is near and dear to my heart. The All-American Scholarship is my heart. And here's why, because when I was, you like that? Oh. Okay, because back in 1997, I had an opportunity to be a scholarship winner. I took the number one spot, and I can just tell you the waves it sent through my career and my opportunities as I interviewed for college or for post-college job opportunities. So if it were to end today, I want to give some props. I'm going to go backwards here. We're going to recognize the top 200 people. This is based on, again, nothing that was sold and sent up this past Monday. If it were to end today, Jordan Maloney, 185, Cassidy Sanborn from Tampa, 182. Jeremy Velez from Caguas, 158. Drew Pope from Tampa, 127 in the company. Okay. Number 112, Katie Phillips from Naples, Matthew from Ocala 109, Claudia Rosas from San Juan, number 105. We got Rudy from Fort Lauderdale, 83. Number 70, Ricardo from Humacao, Claire from Port Charlotte. Miss Bonnie Newman, 61 in the company. Ashley from Tampa, Pekin, number 60. Katie Bishop, number 59 out of Boca. And then Isabel Lopez going to Georgetown next year out of Humacao, number 58. And then rounding out the top 50. So if it ended today, these people would win a scholarship. Ilan from Tampa, or Ellen, if I apologize if I pronounce, is it Ilan from Tampa? Congratulations, you'd be number 46. Nicholas Franklin from Tampa would be number 41. Chloe Corey out of Clearwater, number 30. We have a Sarasota representative, Taylor Rosenthal, would be number 29. Benny Sedlak from Doral, right down the street from me. Doral office, nice job, Jonathan, number 23. And if it were to end today, number 10 in the entire company would be Spencer Trujillo, also out of the Doral office, okay? Awesome, awesome, awesome. We're performing at a high level, everyone. I also want to say thanks for recommending your friends, okay? I think if I can remember to all the trainings we've run, and Andrew and I can relate to just running trainings where it goes from win the prizes to, wow, I'm building the team, to I didn't realize this got me an internship and a management position that changed my life. Seriously, it went from let me go to Cancun to win prizes to, hey, I am building a great team and I have involvement in it, to it is changing how I get opportunities in the future. Whether you're winning prizes like, again, AirPods, signature experiences, whatever the prizes are. And I want to give props to several people. We have one of the largest amount of Cancun winners we have ever had, ever, ever, ever. And we're heading to the Hard Rock Cancun. Unfortunately, the contest ended. So we're going to give some official recognition once the tabs, which is the official counts, come out. But we're so excited to have what's going to be a squad. Unless there were an announcement later on today that would allow more people to attend. Yo no sé mañana. I don't know. There's going to be an announcement later on, everyone. Hold on to your seats. And Andrew Evans has the privilege of announcing something very special regarding Cancun. I also want to say thanks for all of our team builders. If you're working hard, a team builder is someone who is not just recommending friends and putting their friends' names on the app, but they're proactively sitting down with the manager and helping out. We like to reward that in the company. A different scholarship that we will offer is the Campaign 2 Team Builder Scholarship Reward. Okay, you guys can see the levels here. It's pretty straightforward. The scholarship money amount is not what people write home about. It's the opportunity to stand out on your resume and the eliteness of being a top scholarship team builder. That's what people write home about. And we also have two silver cups for that. Why? Because it's that important to our company. We are rocking. I also want to say thanks to the 10K Alliance. Florida Coast, Florida Caribbean, Mondays and Fridays, it's been real. But you know what? What you don't know is that you have now created momentum to come out of the conference. And I'm so excited for this Wednesday and Thursday, Friday Alliance session so we can debrief, we can role play, and we can plan out your summer 2020. So if you're interested, an alliance is where we put the best of the best people together to get advanced coaching and positive pressure, to get the best of the best working with each other, and of course, to get advanced level instruction. I just want to put a little seed out there. SC1 was just the warm-up. The Super Bowl of Pushes is Summer Conference 2, right around the corner. Mark your calendars, coming soon. I want to give props to everyone at Dirty 30. You know, life begins at Dirty 30. You remember that. The job begins at Dirty 30. And if you don't have this already screenshotted and memorized, I would, number one, get this down. And number two, when are you going to hit 30-30? Maybe you struggled to start. Doesn't matter. When will you hit 30-30? Maybe you're already at 30-30. When can you double and triple and quadruple that for the summer? Maybe go for a national scholarship. And eventually, like many of our managers and many of our top sales reps, you get to our elite bonus level, not 30-30, but where you make half, baby. That's 50% commission. Our team is rocking. And before we kick off the event, I think you should know the names and faces. We can't, unfortunately, spotlight everyone due to the massive size. I just want to put into some perspective. Last year, our Summer Conference 1 had in the vicinity of 150 to 200 people total across Puerto Rico and Florida. Today on the Zoom, we have just under 400 people. I'll say it again. We had 150 to 200 people last year. On this Zoom, we have 400 people participating in Summer Conference 1. And I want to say thanks to our leadership team. I want to say thanks on the Florida Coast side. We'll start with our Cutco sales professionals. I want you to note not just how great they look in their headshots. They do look great. Notice the CPO career sales. millions and millions of dollars. And you're going to hear from two people, bottom left and bottom center, Taylor Max and Dylan, today on the program. I want to give props to all of our assistants, and not all the assistants have been listed on this report, but the ones that are here, I just want to say thanks for working really hard, for supporting our offices. I want to recognize our branch managers. Our branch managers working hard as college students. I'm going to not take away from Luke's message too much, but you're going to hear about what the branch internship can do for you, what it did for Luke, and you're going to hear from our nationally ranked branch managers. So Mason Linker from St. Pete, Matt Pizarro from Wesley Chapel, Lindsay Holstrom from Spring Hill, Alex Arias from Sarasota, Jonathan Castell from Doral, Audrey Cruz running our Ocala organization, and Adam Staub from Bradenton. I want to recognize our district managers from Florida Coast. Mr. Mike Abramowitz, our senior district manager running the Tampa team, our new district manager, Mr. Eddie De Las Cuevas in Clearwater, and our number one TLA candidate out of the Florida Coast, serving as an apprentice and running the Coast Pilot Office in Metro Miami, Mr. Adrian Arredondo. I also want to recognize our CSPs over in Florida Caribbean. Again, millions of dollars. And I was mentioning Andy earlier, who started the health clinic over on the left, just a mere $4 million in Cutco sales. Check that out. Props to our assistant manager team in Puerto Rico. And then our branch team, Marlene Lewin from Naples, Alanis Cruzado in Port Charlotte, Christina Fernandez running Ponce, Alejandra Corasco in Humacao, and then Rob Rodriguez running our Palmetto Bay team. Our district manager team in Florida Caribbean, props to Patricia Amador in Mayagüez, Claudia Badillo in Caguas, Orlando Beersin in Fort Myers, David Vargas, our senior district manager in Florida Caribbean in San Juan, Puerto Rico, and the new district manager, Mr. Luke Maseko. And then serving as our pilot sales manager in the Fort Lauderdale office, Miss Milena Amy. I'm also excited that we're going to eventually have to put a slide out. You know what that slide's for? For the 50 to 100 people we're going to promote today to assistant manager intern. We are rocking. So if I could wrap up my opening comments, I want to turn things over to Mr. Evans. I just want to tell you how I started, and I want you to know that I can relate to you. You're going to hear from Hal Elrod today, and I'm going to spare you the bio until it's time for him to unleash his message. But he tells a story of how Cutco changed his life. And you know, back in 1997, Cutco changed my life. This is my 24th summer with Cutco. This is my 23rd year with the company. And it just keeps getting better and better. And what started off as the knife job that my dad thought was the dumbest thing I've ever thought of in my entire life turned into an unbelievable Cutco through college experience, turned into me getting every job offer I wanted because of my 5-star TLA experience, and has turned into a prolific career where now for two decades, I've spent from 19 years old until 42 years old with the same company. And it just keeps getting better. We are rocking. Our opportunity is rocking. So let me give you a couple of tips before I end my message today. MMC DMD, make more calls, do more demos. What's the cure? What's the key? Make more calls, do more demos. I'm having a hard time. Make more calls, do more demos. Get coaching, by the way. I need to get more, make more money. Make more calls, do more demos. Another tip I have to end my comments is just to get on our radar, right? There are opportunities galore. I would be paying attention to what Andrew talks about in Leadership Academy and see how does that fit into helping me and leverage my future opportunity. Not, oh, is that really for me? Because ready, I can tell you, TLA is for everyone if you take advantage of it. And remember, CPO talks, so earn your spot. How do you earn your spot? You do it by texting us like you guys do all day long with all the messages that I want to get on your radar and doing the job, or you accidentally post below Homemaker and then Luke roasts you. Like whatever the number is, make sure you're keeping us up to date. I said this in my sales leadership meeting the other day. I said these meetings are about 30 to 50 to 70 people. Right now, this meeting is 400 people, right? Don't get lost in the mix. There are two individuals here. One of 44 is what Andrew and I serve as. The two of us are one of 44, and our job is to staff Leadership Academy. And in August, we will be interviewing You Want to Earn Your Spot. So make a statement. Make a statement by being at the next event and having an awesome SE2 push. This was just a warm up, but let me give you some quick details so you at least have it. You can screenshot it. You can talk about it. We've got a little while before it starts, but Summer Conference 2, this is the Super Bowl championship push of the summer. SE1 was warm up, get your skills right. SE1 is make mistakes and know what I need to work on. SE1 is let me go to the conference with momentum and come out ready to be a proficient, a prolific, and excited Cutco sales rep to earn my spot. Which leads me to my last few points. You got to bring energy. This company was based on positivity, recognition, support, inclusivity, programs, products, people, and energy. So bring energy to the table. And a really wise, handsome, great-looking, unbelievably charismatic, just, I said, be infectious with your enthusiasm. You ever get on a Zoom and you realize, how am I more excited by hopping on this Zoom when my manager's just getting me pumped up than I am going to any other job I've had before? Because enthusiasm for growth and leadership is infectious. And I just want to encourage you to think about what can happen a year from now. 1 year from now, will you be on the Zoom as a rep? Will you be on the Zoom as an assistant manager? Will you be running your own intern office and you've got between 10, 20, and 30 reps that report to you and that you support and help coach? Will you be a district manager? Will you be a Cutco sales professional? Will you be a division manager one day? And Andrew Evans one day was in a meeting like this at 17, 18 years old. And here he is now running one of 44 organizations in vector marketing. And I'll leave you my final thought. Choose wisely. Choose wisely. Whether you're with Cutco for a long time, doing Cutco through college, maybe you open this up as a potential one of the options that you can choose for your career, or maybe this is just a 1 or 2 summer gig for you. While you're here and when you leave here, choose wisely. Choose the people that are in your circles of influence. And we talk about this in TLA, pretty much every TLA session. There are 3 really important circles in your life. The 2 to 3 people that you take your advice and learn and mentor from. The 2 or 3 people we call peers that you take and do life with. And the 2 or 3 people who you pay it forward and mentor and teach along the way. You can do 3 circles for your personal. You can do it for your business. You can do it for your extracurricular. And I have one for every pass of my life. And I have my golden silver cup circles of influence for my entire life. If everything ended, who did I have to pick as my mentees, my peers, and the people I teach for? Really important. And I can just tell you, I've been blessed to have the opportunity to really make smart choices and have a great family. These are my siblings. The reason I show you my siblings is because every one of those mofos sold Cutco. Every one of them has been a social media recruiting assistant. My sister, my brother on the left, is at 15K in sales. He's a doctor now. He's a pediatric emergency doctor. And the one in the middle with the cool flat bill hat, he's working for the tech industry out in the Bay Area. And he is at about $50,000 in sales, and they all have Cutco vector trained experience. Okay. Choose wisely, choose wisely on the people that support you. You know, not everyone supports everything that we do, but when someone does, like mama, right, and dad, right, when they support you, go to them more. When your manager here supports you, go to them more. When there's a rep on the team, when you're having a tough day and they shine some light and say, you know what, you got this, no worries. Hey, we'll work on it. You got this. Go to them more, okay? Make smart choices. I made a really smart choice. I started dating my now wife. She's awesome. If you guys get a chance to meet Heidi, make smart choices with who you're around. And ready? Jeff, but I'm young. Yeah, that's actually when it's worse. You make poor choices now, it affects you later. Make smart choices. And I want to show you a picture of my wedding because, number one, I spent way too much money on pictures, so I got to show them at some point. They're really expensive and pretty cool. This is in a magazine somewhere, right? But I want to show you this. This is my wedding party. This was on my side. My wife had 5. I wanted 11. Why? Because I can. Okay. And I just said, who are the people I want in my life? And I'm so proud to say, outside of childhood friends, people from my hometown in Baltimore, relatives, half of my wedding party are people from vector marketing. Right? Choose wisely. Choose wisely on the people you spend extracurricular time with. This is some of us out in Wynwood enjoying the evening, participating in extracurricular, if you will. Right? Choose wisely in the people that you invite to your home. Choose wisely in the Cutco sales professional team, right? This is us back when the Florida Caribbean team just started. Look at Heidi's hair, by the way, if you know Heidi. That's how I met her. So cute. And look at this team now. One of the most prolific Cutco sales professional teams in vector marketing. And then there's Florida Caribbean and Florida Coast. 2 dynamic, unbelievable organizations. So I want to end my comments today by saying it is worth your time to grow with us today. It is worth your time to be here. May not be for your career, may not be after college. In fact, for 80% of you, will not be past college. But here, can you gain your skills? Can you build your confidence? Can you grow your resume? And can you get financially independent with us? Because what we do is not about the knives. And if you've been to many of these meetings, you know the same progression of photos I love to show is how it starts. Our job is about mentoring youth. People ask, hey, what do you do for your job? It's about mentoring youth. People ask when I go to these parties and I meet some of Heidi's colleagues at the hospital, They say, oh, what do you do? Oh, I say, I'm in business. And she goes, oh, I do this. And I'll say something smart. Oh, I sell knives. You heard Cutco knives? And Heidi goes, you don't sell knives. You work with kids. Right? And that's what we do. Vector Marketing is the largest college student recruiting company. And we mentor youth. And we grow teams and organizations. And then by the end of the summer, we have unbelievable teams like this one, led by, at the time, college student Luke Maseko in Fort Lauderdale. We do great work, everyone. And our team is rocking. So I hope I was able to set the tone for today. I hope I was able to recognize our key players. And we're going to have an outstanding event. So as this awesome picture says, let's seize it today, right? Let's have an outstanding day. Let's be the most engaged you've ever been. And let's really capitalize on this unbelievable agenda. So right after my opening comments, I'm going to turn things over to Mr. Andrew Evans for our prize drawings and also for our recognition. We've got a break, and at the end of each break, we're going to do the Arrive with 7 drawing. So don't be late. You have to be present to claim your prize. Then we're going to go right into instruction with Taylor Max Ricart. Andrew will talk about Leadership Academy, and then we wrap up the second half of the meeting with some wham, bam, unbelievable instruction that will take us home. And to wrap up our meeting, we have keynote speaker, Mr. Hal Elrod. Quick announcements, including our MVP awards at the end of the meeting, and then Andrew Evans is going to set us on fire. So thank you for your time. Thank you ahead of time for being the most unbelievable group of engaged students here for Summer Conference One. And I'm going to turn things over to my colleague, Mr. Andrew Evans. Thanks, everybody.
All right. Thank you, Jeff. Well, I have the pleasure of doing some recognition here for our SC1 push countdown. So get your